Students, I'm Krishna Vaga, your math teacher, and today we are going to discuss the exercise number 4.1 from the chapter Linear Equation in One Variable. So our first question is, the cost of a notebook is twice the cost of a pen. Write a linear equation in two variables to represent this statement. Okay, what we have to do, a statement is given to us that the cost of the notebook is twice the cost of the pen. So we have to write down it in the form of linear equation. Here it is also given that we have to take the cost of notebook as x rupees and the cost of pen as y rupees. So if we consider cost of the notebook is equal to rupees x and the cost of pen as rupees y, then the cost of the notebook is equal to twice the cost of pen. So x is equal to 2y, and x, if we take 2y on the left hand side, so it will be x minus 2y is equal to 0. So this is how we can represent the equation, the statement in the form of linear equation. Now the next question, express the following linear equation in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. That is the general form of the linear equation, and indicate the values of a, b and c in each case. So here some parts are given of this question. So what we have to do, we have to find out the values of a, b, c. What is a? A is the coefficient of x, b is the coefficient of y, and c is the constant term in a general form of linear equation. Here the equation given to us is 2x plus 3y is equal to 0.95 bar. So if we take this 0.95 bar on the left hand side, the equation becomes 2x plus 3y minus 9.35 bar is equal to 0. Now we have converted this equation in the form of general equation. Okay, now we will compare the values. So coefficient of x is 2, that means the value of a is 2. And coefficient of y is 3, that means the value of b is 3, and the constant term is minus 9.35 bar. So the value of c is minus 9.35 bar. So this is how we can get the values of all the terms. Now the second part. The second part is x minus y upon 5 minus 10 is equal to 0. Here we can see that the term is already given in the form of general. In general form. So we can see here that the value of a would be 1, value of b would be minus 1 upon 5, and the value of c is minus 10 is equal to 0. So these are the value of this, the value from this part. Now the third part is, minus 2x plus 3y is equal to 6. Now what we will do, we will take this 6 on the left hand side. So it will become minus 2x plus 3y minus 6 is equal to 0. Now it is in general form. So here we can compare this general form with the general form ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. So we can easily compare that the value of a is minus 2 and the value of b is plus 3 and the value of c is minus 6. Now the fourth part. In the fourth part, the given term equation is x is equal to 3y. Now in this equation, we will take 3y on the left hand side, so it will become x minus 3y is equal to 0. Here you can see that constant term is missing, so we can write down 0 instead of constant term, because if we add or subtract 0 from any number, it remains as it is. So here again, comparing with the general form, that is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, we can easily see that the value of a is equal to 1, as nothing is, no coefficient is written in along with x, so we will consider that 1 is the coefficient. So a is equal to 1, b is equal to 3, and c is equal to 0. Now the fifth part. In fifth part, it is given that 2x is equal to minus 5y. Now if we take 5y on the left hand side, it will become 2x plus 5y plus 0 is equal to 0, because constant is not given here, so we will consider 0 as constant. So again, comparing with the general form, that is ax plus by plus c, we will can easily say that the value of A is 2, B is 5 and C is equal to 0. Next question is question number 7th part of this question, that is y minus 2 is equal to 0. Now here you can see that the term of x is missing. So we can write it as 0 multiplied by x, because x is not there. So we can write it as 0 multiplied by x plus y minus 2 is equal to 0. And why comparing this with the general form, that is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, we can easily see that a is equal to 0, b is equal to 1, c is equal to minus 2. Okay. Then now the next part, 5 is equal to 2x. Here we can see that only x term is given to us and y term is missing. Now it could be done in two ways. Either we can shift 5 on the left right hand side, or we can move x 2x on the left hand side. Both could be done. Here we will shift 2x on right left hand side, so it will become minus 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. Now y term is missing over there, so we will write down 0 into y in place of the missing term. So it become minus 5x plus 0y plus 5 is equal to 0. So on comparing with the general form, that is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, it will easily see that a is equal to minus 2, b is equal to 0 and c is equal to 5. So that's all about this exercise.